Hi, everybody. I'm Mike with Lenovo, and I'm here with the ThinkCenter M73 series, which is available in three form factors. We have a tower, the small, and the tiny. Today, we're going to be replacing the CMOS battery in the small form factor. The process will take about 5 minutes, and it should be easy enough for anyone to do. No tools are required to do this. Before we continue, we want to make sure that we're protected against electrostatic discharge, or ESD. For more information on ESD, click the link in the description. Now let's get started. First, you want to remove the two thumb screws. And then slide the cover back and lift it. Now we want to pop the clips loose on the front bezel and then open it and remove it. And we still have a cable here that goes inside. And now we need to open the drive bay assembly. We just want to open it until this latch pops and locks it open. Now we need to disconnect the power button cable from the system board. And now we have these two clips that hold the cable in place. You twist to open the clips, and then you can pull the cable out. So now we just need to pull the front bezel away from the system and feed this cable through the hole in the chassis. And now we need to lay the system down flat on the table. To remove the fan duct, you pull slightly outward on the tabs and lift it straight up and out of the system. To remove the CMOS battery, you press outward on the latch until it pops out of the slot. Then you can lift it out of the system. And here we have the replacement CMOS battery that will go into the system. To replace the CMOS battery, you set the battery into the slot positive side up and press straight down until it snaps into place. To replace the fan duct, you just set it in place over the fan and push it straight down until the tabs snap. So now we need to stand the system back up to put the front bezel back on. We need to feed the power button cable through the hole in the chassis and pull it all the way through. Now we gotta make sure the cable goes back into the clips and you twist the clip to close it. Now we need to reconnect the power button cable to the system board. Now we need to close the drive bay assembly. We want to press down on the blue touch point on that latch, which allows you to close it. And then you just make sure it closes all the way. And now we want to align the hinge clips with the holes in the chassis and then close the front bezel like a door. We place the cover onto the system and slide it forward, then replace the two thumb screws.